So previously we have talked about two main definitions, AQL, acceptable quality limit, and RQL or rejectable quality limit, also known as LTPD. RQL is also known as LTPD, lot tolerance percent defective. And based on that, we also talked about OC curve. Let's look at OC curve a little bit more, and then later on we will actually draw an OC curve. Let's understand OC curve here. So initially also we said that there is an ideal OC curve. Ideal OC curve is this. This one is ideal. This one basically segregates good lot and bad lots very efficiently. Any lot which comes with less than 1.5% defective, in our case, in our example, gets accepted. Any lot with more than 1.5% defective gets rejected. Probability is 1 if the percent defective in the lot is 1.5% or less than that. The probability is 0 when the percentage defective in that lot is more than 1.5%. So poor lots get rejected, good lots get accepted. This is the ideal case. But in reality, we said that there are errors. Type 1 error, type 2 error. Type 1 error is also called as alpha, or the producer's risk, because good lot will get rejected. Second error or type 2 error is called as beta, or the buyer's risk or the consumer's risk. This is the risk that you might accept a bad lot. And all these things will happen when you do sampling. When you do sampling, you will sometimes accept a bad lot and sometimes you will reject a good lot, because this is all based on the probability. So here, if I have 2 points, AQL, which is the acceptable quality limit, which is 1.5% in my example, and we said that 8% is our maximum level of defect which we can accept, which is RQL. We want to reject anything beyond this 8%. So we have 2 points here, and we have 2 points here, which is alpha and beta. Alpha is, in our case, let's say 0.95. We want to have the producer's risk as 0.05 or 5%. 5% risk the producer has to take. And let's say 10% is the beta, or 10% is the buyer's or the consumer's risk. So based on these 4 things, we have these 2 points. These 2 points basically will define the shape of the OC curve. So once you have these 4 numbers, then you can plot an OC curve. We will actually go through the process of plotting OC curve using Poisson distribution in the next video. But before that, let's stick to OC curve only. So in OC curve, now your question could be, why can't we have ideal curve? If this is the ideal one, why can't we just have the ideal curve as an OC curve? The answer to that is, for ideal curve, you will need to do 100% inspection. So if you inspect every item, then only you can have an ideal curve. Ideal curve will be, if you get 1000 items, you check each and every item. Each and every item, once you check, then you know that 15 items defective is level of acceptance in that out of 1000. 1.5% of 1000 is 15 items. So if you get 15 or less items which are rejected in that 100% inspection, you take the whole lot. If you get, let's say, 16 items which are rejected, you reject the lot. But then that is not the purpose of sampling. That's not the purpose of acceptance sampling, because if you have to do everything, if you have to inspect every item, then there is no point of having acceptance sampling. So that's the reason you don't have ideal curve. You have a curve which is something similar to this one. This might have a different slope depending on how many pieces you are picking. So out of 1000 items, if you just pick 10 items and based on that you want to decide, you might have a different slope. Instead, if you take 100 items out of that, you will have a different slope. If you pick 100 items, you will be a little bit more confident. Little bit more confident means your OC curve will be a little bit more towards the ideal curve. So that will change the shape, something like, let's say, this more steeper curve. More steeper curve means more near to the ideal curve. So for having this steeper curve, you will need to pick more items, pick more samples. In OC curve, you have 3 different zones, acceptable, rejectable, and indifferent quality. And we have talked about that earlier as well. acceptable is anything which is less than 1.5% in our example. Rejectable is anything which is greater than 8% in the example we took. And in between that is indifferent quality. Indifferent means there is a good chance of acceptance or rejection. It's all based on chance. So this is how, if you see the OC curve, the green part is the acceptable zone, which is less than 1.5%. Red is the rejectable, which is more than the RQL, which we said in our case is 8%. And anything in between these two numbers, between 1.5 to 8% is our indifferent quality. We are not sure whether we want that or not. This is all will be left to chance. So if you get a lot which has, let's say, 4% defective, might get accepted, might not get accepted. So we are indifferent about that. We don't want to talk about that. We are just focusing on two things. Less than 1.5%, we are good with that. More than 8%, we don't want that lot. So this is how you can divide your OC curve into three separate zones. Now let's move on to the next lecture and see how do we plot an OC curve using Poisson distribution.